Explain to us the significance of this apparently rather unique date range, 12-12-12, apparently. We haven't found anybody that's sort of as anything else other than a date range, but anyway.
It's just another day for me. Fortunate not to be working today on such a beautiful day.
What time did you get out of bed?
I woke up at about 7 o'clock, but I didn't get out of bed until about 9:30.
And what were you wearing? December the 12th. 12-12-12, yes. Oh, you've heard about it. Have you seen our website? Anyway, it doesn't matter. No, sorry. Okay, all right.
Well, the media needs something to focus on every day, and they've had this issue to focus on all year and to create a little bit more fear.
Do you hope the world will come to an end?
I love this world, and I love the people and the animals on the world.
Oh, do you love me?
Oh no, a lot of people are getting married at the moment. A significant date to get married. Well, that's a big mistake for you, because
I got.
Hey,
we're interviewing
here.
Can you just get out?
I do, actually. Do you find me attractive?
I love you in a different kind of way.
Oh, okay. All right.
Can you just get out?
I got married. No. I got married and it was doomed to fail. And if I'd seen someone like this that's going to do that, I'd just say, hey, have a think about it. Buy the person you don't like a house and give it to them.
Maybe it means oneness.
Well, how can it mean one? Because it's 12, 12, 12. That's like 36 or...
Yeah, but...
3 plus 6 is 9. Or...
Yeah, but 12 plus 12... minus 12...
still 12.
Different people have said it's got to do with the Mayan calendar. So the 12th or 12th. Some people say it's the 21st or the 12th, actually. And one particular scientist that I studied and stuff, he's... actually believe that the Mayan calendar ended on the 28th of November last year.
Numbers are just concepts and we give them importance, and you know, maths is one of those arts really where you try and figure out the mind of God.
My understanding of what people think of it is the end of the Mayan calendar.
So the world hasn't actually ended now, has it?
Their theory is that it's...
just like 11-11-11 was for a certain group of people, and they wreaked great destruction.
Consciousness speeds up with each step of the pyramid or the time schedule. So with each bit, consciousness speeds up a bit, and then at the end of it, consciousness gets into no time. So
see it as a change that you'll be making with the idea of it, or is it...
No, sorry.
As consciousness speeds up at the end of the Mayan calendar, which is like a pyramid, each time is shorter. The last one was supposed to take 20 days for consciousness to manifest. That's the last tier of the pyramid.
It's the last repeating day for a long time, so I think that's a bit significant.
12th letter of the...
12th letter of the alphabet is an L.
Is an L for Lisa, which is your name. I think I'm seeing a pattern there. So the pattern is that the 12th letter of the alphabet being an L, and the L being the first letter of your name, Lisa. We're onto something.
I'm very attached to the number 10 too, because I work for the campaign for 10-cent refunds on bottles and cans.
Oh.
10 cents can change Australia.
So okay, 10. So okay, but what's that got to do with 12? So the significance of 12-12-12 to you, it must be significant. Two for yes, one for no. Oh, good on you.
The tier before that, it took 260 days. The tier before that, which was all of them.
And people are becoming more aware and a lot more intuitive and a lot more kind of connected to their higher self.
I think it will affect physically eventually, but I think it will start out, or has started out, as an energetic or a consciousness level shift. I think a lot of the man-made structures that support the way of life that we have now are going to come crashing down.
It's a big global shift in consciousness.
I look at where we've gotten by having a society that values the individual over the whole, and it's really not working for us.
People are waking up, there's natural disasters, the world is literally being shaken up.
And what we do to this planet does matter, and you know, that's going to impact not just us now, but you know, future generations.
Changes in people's attitudes, you can hear it in music, you can read it in books and see it, you know, with the social media and all that sort of stuff. It is, people are becoming more aware, and that's where we're going. And
my phone screen's smashed, I haven't dropped it. My flatmate's car's dead after she's just had it serviced for no apparent reason. Her brand new phone's gone dead. You know, the battery charger's died. It just doesn't make any sense.
It's an opportunity for us to come together and shift and change and move through and grow. You know, you don't just close the public school system one day and have everyone out on the streets. If you own that, you're all a, that we're all a part of this and we've all participated in it, whether it's been this lifetime or many others, either through our own physical body being here or through us participating in the consciousness, because all of it exists together within the consciousness and we all have that within all of our minds. You can look at it many multiple ways, yeah?
Yeah.
At the end of the day, we all are participating. That's really what it's about. Yep, it's every moment us reminding each other who we are for each other. There's no more separation, it's everyone, you know? It used to be that, you know, the like-minded, so they hang around the Gnostic corner versus the ones at the salvos, versus the ones at the petrol stations, yeah? To me, they're all part of that as well. Look at it that way, that they're all a part of one. Life is so much easier. Life is so much more gracious. So, and why wouldn't you? They're all the same, because they're all a part of me. Even if he has a completely different belief system than me, he's still a part of me. To me, that is the consciousness. We have the opportunity to create it ourselves because we're learning that we are the gods we've been looking for. We are the change that we are seeking. It's just that we're still not quite, we're still new at that concept. So to me, 12 is for those who are there, for those who choose to say, you know what, I like that idea. I'm tired of the suffering. I'm tired of the bullshit or the fear. I'm tired of being dominated and controlled by others. I'm tired of listening and not being able to speak my truth. I'm going to go with this new one. I like this idea. And I'm going to see how I go. I'm going to play that game for a little while and see what happens. And to me, that's the opportunity. So people, that's why there's, I think there's already a lot of energy and synergy around all of that. People are already just going, yeah, that's good for me. I'll take that one. And you know what? I've studied many teachings and I recognize that it's there. The light and the dark are in every teaching. It is only different words, but the heart or the messages are all the same. So to me, people can stop looking for another way, another book, or another religion. And if they just started practicing the one that they are in currently, and really look for the answers outside of what they've been told from their priests, or their community leaders, or their teachers, they will find the answers. They don't actually need to keep, you know, like we say, the truth comes from within. It's all there already. In fact, I think, if anything, we need to start stripping away like an onion all those layers that have been put upon us since birth and get back to the truth, because the truth is you are the same as me.
I don't believe the world's coming to an end.
Are you sure? Because we've had some interesting theories regarding that.
I'm moving house.
So to you, it's just another bloody date. Is that it?
Yeah, pretty much.
Can I just ask, did you get much for that camera?
Anything else you want to get rid of?
Look, I've got this pool table.
I struggle with it in my mind.
Numerology-wise, 12-12-12 is auspicious and, you know, they're powerful numbers when all put together. So I think it's a global awareness and we're shifting in consciousness.
I don't have all the answers. I don't know how it'll all work or whether it will all work sort of thing. But, you know, I think we're definitely due for a change, a big one.
So this time period is the, they call it the end of time, not the end of the world. So it's where time no longer is a hindrance to bring an idea into creation. That's my basic understanding.
Are you interested in buying a pool table?
No, I don't have space. I would be if I had space.
Are you still here?
Oh, we're just interviewing. Sorry.
Oh, Val, come on, man.
Oh, come on. I'll give it. It's my last one, please.
I don't know. We've been put out with your shit for ages.
Okay,
guys.
But I just like, look, it's just my last interview. I've been like here all
that's
day.
Not, no, that's
come
not,
on,
okay. Somebody. Right,
fine.
Somebody
fine.
Has to tell you nobody cares.
Oh,
all
look,
right.
Please.
Nobody cares. I'm
all
sorry,
we're trying
guys.
To do is
I know what you're trying
this
to do.
Is
but
why.
Nobody
this
gives
is
a
see,
shit.
I told you they weren't
well,
taking this seriously.
I've been coming here forever, and you're treating us like this.
Look, I'm sorry, but somebody has to tell him. Get a grip, man. Get a life out. Oh.